As stated earlier, a plant has basically two types of root system, that is, root and shoot system. As we all know, that root system basically comprises of roots, which we have already studied earlier. Now we study about shoot system. Shoot system basically possesses stem, leaves, flower, fruits, which we will all study in detail one by one. Let's begin with stem. Stem is considered as the aerial part of plant axis. It is negatively geotrophic, that is, away from the gravity. Positively phototrophic, that is, towards the sun. It basically develops from plumule. It is distinguished into internodes and nodes. Leaves basically arises from nodes. This region between two successive nodes is known as internode. An apical bud occurs at the tip of the stem. It causes elongation of the main axis of the stem. An axillary bud occurs in the axil of the leaf. This axil is the angle formed by the node with the stem, from which leaves arises. Initially the stem is green, but later gradually with the time it turns woody. Till now we have studied about stem. Now we will study detail about branching, that is, branches that develop from axillary buds. The development and arrangement of branches on stem is known as branching. There are basically two types of branching: dichotomous and lateral branching. Lateral branching is further divided into two types, that is, racemose and cymose. Now we will study each of the type of branching in detail. First of all, let us begin with dichotomous branching. In this type of branching, the apical bud continuously divides into two branches, which further divides into two, and it continues the same. Second type of branching is lateral branching. In this, the branches are produced on the lateral sides, which further continues to do the same. Unlike dichotomous one, in which the apical bud continuously divides into two branches. There are basically two types of lateral branching, racemose and cymose. Let us study each of them in detail. In racemose type of branching, the axillary buds on the main axis produces new branches continuously in an acropetal fashion, that is, alternately, that we can see from the figure. These branches develop and also do the same. As a result, the plant becomes a conical or pyramidal in shape. Example, Casuarina. Next type of branches is cymose. Here, the apical bud of the stem becomes inactive after some time. As a result, branches can be produced from this axil of the leaf under it. As a result, branching stops after some time. The branching formed in this way is known as cymose branching. Cymose is further divided into three types: uniparous, biparous and multiparous. If a single branch develops in this way, then the branching pattern is known as uniparous cymose. Similarly, if two branches develops in this way, then it is called biparous cymose. Further, if many branches develops in this way, then they are called multiparous. Uniparous branching is further divided into two types: helicoid and scorpoid. If the branches developing in such a way are formed only on one side, that is either right or left, then such a type of branching is known as helicoid branching. Example, Ashoka tree. Similarly, in scorpoid type, if the branches are formed alternately on two sides, then such a branching is known as scorpoid. Example, vitis. In multiparous type, if the axis of the stem is formed by union of many lateral branches, then the axis is known as sympoidal axis. Thus, branching of stem is basically of two types: dichotomous and lateral. Further, lateral branching is divided into two types: racemose and cymose. Further, cymose type of branching is basically of three types: uniparous, biparous, and multiparous. Uniparous cymose is further basically divided into two types: helicoid and scorpoid. In dichotomous branching, the apical bud continuously divides into two main branches, which further continues to do the same. On the contrary, in lateral branching, the branches are produced on lateral side. Further, two types, racemose and cymose. In racemose type of branching, the axillary buds on the main axis produces new branches in an acropatal fashion. In cymose type of branching, the apical bud from where the branches arises becomes inactive after some time, and thereby branching stops out there. So further, branching starts but from the next apical bud of the stem. If all the branches formed are either on one side, then it is called uniparous branching. Similarly, if two branches are developed in this way, it is biparous, and if more than two branches are developed in this way, then it is called multiparous. In uniparous, if the branches are developed either on left or right or on single side, then it is known as helicoid. On the contrary, in scorpoid, the branches are developed on the alternate sides. In racemose, since the branching arises from a single main stem, that axis is known as monopodial axis. On the contrary, since the axis of the stem is formed by union of many lateral branches, it is known as dipodial or sympodial axis. The basic feature of stem is that it may be aerial or underground, generally in most plants. Stem is erect, strong and woody, which develops gradually with time. Further, in few plants, the stems can be delicate, thread-like or weak. which basically acts as climbers or trainers and are used for climbing. This we'll study later in detail. What are the normal functions of this stem? Now we will study in detail about the normal functions of stem. As we all know that the stem conducts water and lymph and other necessary salts towards the conductive tissues in roots, from leaves and vice versa. Second point is that it arranges leaves in such a manner that it can obtain sufficient light to carry out the process of photosynthesis. Third, that it arranges flowers, fruits, seeds like reproductive organs of the plant in such a proper manner that processes like fertilization, pollination, and dispersal of seeds can be carried out very easily. These are the normal functions of stem that are carried out by all the plants having stem. Now we will study about these functions of stem that are carried out only by few plants, specialized plants. First is storage of food. Underground plants possessing stem carry out a special function of storage of food. In order to understand, let us consider three examples which carry out such a function. In ginger, the underground stem grows parallel to the ground surface, which gradually with time becomes flesh due to storage of food. It possesses nodes, internodes, scaly leaves, adventitious roots and buds. Such a modified stem is known as rhizome or rootstock. Which is the modified stem of ginger used to store food. Now let us understand about another example, that is potato. In potato, the axils of the underground scaly leaves branches develop. They store food in their apical region, which gradually with time becomes round or oval. Such a modified stem of potato is known as tubers, that is used to store food. Buds with scaly leaves occur on the pits of tubers of potato. Such a pit is known as eye. With the help of these eyes, potatoes carry out the process of vegetative propagation, that is their reproduction process, which is also a specialized function of stem. Another example is Amorphophallus. In amorphophallus, the condensed form of rhizome, that is, the modified stem for storage of food or potato, occurs, which is called as corm. It is a food structure that is made up of only one internode. Now let us study about another special function, that is vegetative propagation. These modifications are of subaerial stems. A part of the stem is underground and that of the remaining part is above ground. In this, long branches develop out of spare stem, which possesses nodes and internodes that run parallel to the ground, irrespective of the normal one, which is aerial and above the ground. In order to understand the special modification of stem that carry out vegetative propagation, there are basically three basic type of examples that are used to understand this method. Runner, offset and stolon are basically modified stem that is used to carry out the vegetative propagation. Now let us understand all of them in detail. From the nodes which come in contact with the ground, here new plants are produced. Such a modification of stem is known as runner. Another modification of stem known as offset, generally present in aquatic plants like Pistia. Short, thick and horizontal branches arising from the basal region develops with the increasing time. Such branches are known as offset. In generally plants like strawberry, branches arise from the basal regions which grow obliquely and come in contact with the ground, producing new plants. Such a modified stem is known as stolon, which generally occurs in the form of new branches. Third special function of stem is protection. In few plants like rose, pomegranate, pichal or axillary bud of the stem gets transformed into pointed structures. Such pointed structures are known as either thorns in pomegranate, prickles in roses. Sometimes leaves and flowers are also grown on the thorn. The pointed, carved and sharp structures produced on the surface of the stem of roses is called prickles. These are not exactly the modification of stem but are considered as the outgrowth from the surface. But as it is a part of stem, it helps and protects the plant from the external surfaces. Another special function of cell, which is caused by the modification of stem, is climbing. In plants like passion flower, another function is photosynthesis. Now, as we all know, the photosynthesis is one of the basic functions carried out by leaves. But since few plants also carry out this process with the help of specialized stem. It is considered as one of the special functions of stem of few plants. Plants living in dry habitats like Opuntia shed their leaves to reduce transpiration, that is loss of water. For such plants, there are specialized stems which are green, possesses chlorophyll, which is an important factor or which is an important pigment to carry out the process of photosynthesis, and are generally flat. Such stems of plants which carry out photosynthesis are known as phylloclades. Thus, phylloclades are specialized stems used to carry out the process of photosynthesis in plants living in dry habitats. And last specialized function of stem is reproduction. In few plants, axillary buds gets transformed and stores food. As a result, they become fleshy. As studied earlier, such plants later separate from the parental plant and produces new plants. Such a specialized function is basically performed or occurs in plants like agave or Dioscorea. Such a modified stem which occurs in the form of bud, that is axillary bud, is known as bulbin, which is used to carry out the reproduction process and for the storage of food.